Alright guys, you might have seen different methods to remove bloatware from any Android phone, but all those methods either require a PC or your phone needs to be rooted, or some methods also use two different Android phones. Well, in today's video, I'll show you an excellent way to remove any Android bloatware using a single Android phone. This method uses two different applications, one is called as Shizuku and the second one is called as Aishel. And I have tested this method on different devices like Xiaomi, Vivo and Samsung. Let's go ahead and take a look at a step-by-step guide on how to use these two applications to remove any Android bloatware. And please check the timestamps in the video description for easy access. Like any other methods, the first important step is to enable developer options in your phone. I'm using a Samsung device here, so you can go to About Phone, then Software Version and tap on this build number multiple times, until you get a banner message saying that you are a developer now. You can then go back, open developer options and enable USB debugging first, and then enable wireless debugging as well. And please do not worry about any pop-ups here, just allow all of them. Step number 2 is very important, so please make sure you pay your attention so that you do not miss any important step here. And I also wanted to let you guys know that I won't be going into detail about the application features because that's going to make this video very long. But to make things a bit short, both Shizuku and Aishel are open source applications that are capable of doing some really powerful things in Android devices. I'll place the download links for both these applications in the video description, so make sure you have both of them installed in your phone before you start with this process. Now, setting up Shizuku is a bit complicated and I will try my best to make things easier. After downloading Shizuku on your phone, the first thing is to enable notification permissions. So just long press on the application and go to application information and turn on notifications. While you are in this information page, remove all the battery restrictions so that the Android system does not kill this application in the background. In some devices like Xiaomi, you will get an option of auto start right here, and it is better to enable auto start as well to avoid any unnecessary issues. As I am doing all this in my Samsung phone, these settings might be different for different devices, so please make sure you follow all the steps carefully before moving any further. After you are done with all these steps, you can go ahead and open Shizuku, and this is how the main interface of the application looks like. And please do not worry about any extra features here, we are just going to use a few of them. Now we need to pair the device with Shizuku, so please go ahead and tap on pairing, and it will ask you to open developer options. Tap on developer options and search wireless debugging, and that should be turned on like I mentioned in the beginning of this video. If you take a closer look here, the left side of wireless debugging is clickable, so you can just tap on it and you will see an option of connecting through a pairing code. Just tap on connect through a pairing code and you should get a code here along with a notification from Shizuku about entering the code. Please enter the code and tap on this send button and the connection should be successful. And if you go back and open Shizuku, it should get automatically connected. But please note that it is a very tricky process and you need to have some patience because all the steps I mentioned here look very easy actually, but they are not. And there's a high chance that you might face some issues on the way and Shizuku might not get connected to your phone. So you have to perform troubleshooting. If the application does not get connected, try to disable wireless debugging and then enable it again. If you are using a Xiaomi phone, you already know how bad it is going to be because Xiaomi does not want you to move away from MIUI or do any kind of modifications. You can also try the user guide that Shizuku developers have provided and it is very easy to read and follow. And if nothing works, you can also comment and I will try my best to help you guys. Now Shizuku is connected, next you have to open the second application called Aishel. As soon as you open this application, it will ask for Shizuku permission, please enable it first and there you have a first look at the application interface. Now this application is very interesting, you will get ready-made commands for different functions. As we are dealing with Android bloatware, we will just concentrate on those particular commands. If you type uninstall in the search bar, you will get a set of different commands here, and you can try any of them depending on your device. As I am using a Samsung phone here, I will select the command that works here, and if you know the package name, just type it, or get the package name of any application using package name Viewer 2.0 that's available for free on Google Play Store. Once you get the package name, type it and tap enter and the application is going to be removed from your phone. You can also try other commands to freeze or disable the applications and it is super easy. And after you are done with all this, you can delete both these applications, or if you want to do some more research, you can take a look at other powerful features of Shizuku because there is a huge list of open source applications that work with Shizuku. I'll place a link to a GitHub article in the video description that contains a well-defined list of open source applications that's going to make your Android experience much better. And the information I shared in this video is just very small. If you want to unleash the complete power of Shizuku, I highly recommend checking this GitHub article and I'm sure you're not going to regret it. And that's all for today's video and I hope I was able to make things a bit easier here. If you have any questions or queries, you can drop a comment, or if you want to try some other methods to remove Android bloatware. I have already made a couple of other videos on this topic and you should be able to see them on your screen right now. And if this is your first time on this channel, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on channel notifications so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.